Dying in Battle Royale is a safe that no one has cracked yet. Numerous titles have come close, such as Apex Legends and Fortnite, but our best contender here is Warzone and its Gulag. In my most recent video, I made this statement. It doesn't absolutely fix the issue of dying in Battle Royale, but it comes closer than all its competitors. But what if there was a way to absolutely fix the issue? Well, today, I give you my solution. Here's the idea. Although Battle Royale games have you playing as a squad, you never truly play for your teammates and absolutely work together towards a common goal. You see, dying in a standard Battle Royale results in certain consequences, some of which are permanent. Therefore, the player is always that bit more cautious, and most of the time this results in the player putting themselves ahead of their teammates. That's not to say that teamwork doesn't occur, but for you, losing a teammate either temporarily or permanently is preferable to yourself dying. So how do we encourage teamwork in a battle royale whilst ensuring the player dying is not an unforgiving experience? We introduce a vehicle. I'm basing this idea off of Sea of Thieves, but there are countless games that could implement such a concept. In this case, we will use a ship. The ship acts as the squad's health, so to speak. If the ship sinks, you lose, no exceptions. Having said that, the players on the ship can die and respawn as many times as they like. I know you probably have a lot of questions, so let me try to iron out some of the details. Firstly, how do we drop in? We can't parachute, so I have two potential fixes. 1. Randomly spawn in the ships, spreading players evenly across the map. 2. Mark spawn locations across the map and let squads pick, based on a first-come, first-serve basis, whilst ensuring the squads don't spawn too near to each other. I think either could work, but let me know which one you prefer. Okay, so secondly, a huge aspect of Battle Royale is looting. The problem here is that Sea of Thieves is an equal grounds game. Everyone has the same equipment, so unfortunately we're going to have to break that in order to encourage players to fight and explore. However, the caveat here is that all upgrades only go towards the ship. We'll get to that soon, but for now, looting involves just obtaining supplies. Players could spawn with basic equipment, but would have to loot in order to obtain food, ammo, planks, cannonballs, etc. As mentioned, we will be upgrading the ship. This will involve aspects such as the hull, cannons, sails, and even rams. Each aspect could have 5 tiers, with starting ships having no tiers whatsoever. Players can earn these upgrades by either completing contracts or by performing actions relative to that aspect. So for example, the more you use your ram, the better it will get. This will be small compared to completing contracts, which give larger rewards. Each aspect will upgrade automatically once you have earned enough experience to level up a tier. Contracts are very similar to Warzone, whereby the squad is given a task such as to hunt down a player or capture a zone. These could be expanded upon in Sea of Thieves. Examples might include fishing, hunting, clearing an area of skeletons, monster hunting, and even A to B time trials. All would give experience towards a certain aspect or multiple aspects and improve your ship. The harder the contract, the greater the reward, and of course, only one contract at a time. These contracts are found whilst looting, which begs the question, what do we do with the countless outposts that are used in the standard game to accept voyages? Well, they're gone, as here they would serve no purpose. Perhaps they could be abandoned, or converted into AI outposts, which could be captured by accepting a certain contract. Of course, many features of the Battle Royale genre will be prevalent here. One of these features is the storm or circle. I think an actual storm here would work. The longer the game goes on, the stronger it gets, and you can last longer in the storm with a better hull. And understandably, the final 2-4 circles would have to be on at least 90% water. We don't want the final circles to be on land. PvP is a crucial characteristic of this mode, and we need to determine how we can permanently kill another team and where players respawn. Ships can sink for 3 reasons. 1. The most common scenario, they receive too much cannon fire. 2. They get attacked by a kraken. Or 3. an inside job. Because your ship is your health, it will naturally lead to players staying on their ship out of fear. To further motivate them to enjoy a variety of gameplay elements, we introduce a new item, dynamite. This will replace the gunpowder barrel. Now don't worry, this can't be thrown or put in a cannon. The only way to use dynamite is to place it inside the bottom level of an enemy ship. Here, it will take 20 seconds to explode and 7 seconds to disarm. An explosion of dynamite automatically brings down a ship. They would be found whilst looting, and a player can only carry one at a time. This would inspire almost guerrilla-type warfare, and could result in some very sneaky and very clever kills. Players respawn on their ship within 5 to 10 seconds of dying. There could also be an option to spawn on a teammate if the surrounding area is safe. It's worth noting that players drop all their supplies if they die, and we will put a fair limit on the amount of supplies one can carry. If you destroy an enemy ship, 1-4 crates of supplies will remain, which you can plunder. This includes any supplies which are on the players. Full weather and day and night cycles, a cosmetic progression system based on feats achieved in the mode, different varieties of modes such as duos, trios. They could even introduce mammoth-sized ships and have 10 squads of 10. However, at this stage, I think you get the point. This hypothetical game mode would crack the issues of teamwork and dying in Battle Royale, giving players something to collectively care about. It's not perfect, but hey, it's just an idea.